thanks so much for listening. Enjoy the rest of the night. In my current dream, we have a daughter with a boyfriend with a mustache with a taste for younger women. Like our daughter, he has a little habit. When he tries to make a point, he points his finger. Which if it had not been eaten by a table saw when he was 23, would really help to emphasize his point. Instead, we are distracted by the sight of the missing joint. And no one hears a word he says in my recurring dream. Yes, in my recurring dream, I give a man a $20 bill. Cause he likes Smokey Robinson, lives on the street, but still will never confuse the temptations with the miracles. When he walks in the grocery and he hears them on the radio, and I'm singing it on the street, but glad he can feel the thrill. Tracks of my tears comes on and then Blueberry Hill. So here's my $20 bill in my recurring dream. Yes, in my recurring dream, and this one comes too often. There's a plane filled with people with carry-on coffins, and I've done all the rules regarding karma. But I suspect that when the good outweighs the bad, some automatic self-protection kicking in. Here you got this plane, and as it starts to rise, I can see the panic in every pair of eyes. The silent voice is calling in slow motion, trapped, falling and falling. Wake up, you sleepyhead. Yeah, get out of bed, cheer up. The sun is straight over. I was 11 when it started. I'm standing in my backyard shooting arrows at a target. While inside the house, my mother, now remarried, says last night's untimely death of my dad. She leans over the couch where he's still lying to kiss him. And it's not that we are ghoulish, it's just that we would miss him. So we leave him there a little while longer. And a good thing to I guess was dying. Stronger. 3 days later, he gets up to watch the news, and the news is often bad, and the news is often sad. I know a lot of us are happier when we're sad. Wake up, sleepyhead, get out of bed, cheer up. The sun is straight overhead. We are drawbridge operators that cannot see each other as we pull the ropes and raise the rope. This cloud above me, it suddenly explodes into a million little lullabies that fall into my ears. They steal my attention, but they take away my fears. So when I slip off the rope and fall through the icy waves, I realize it's not Jesus. It's music that saves, and the fish swimming by me with faces like boats. I send it to the darkness, but I still.